So, in last class, we have discussed about n-grams. So, today we are going to finish this n-grams discussion over these n-grams. And I'm audible, right?
Yes, ma'am.
And screen is visible.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, we are going to discuss like how we are going to process these n-grams further and give these into our model. And what are the technicalities about these n-grams we are going to discuss, and we are going to finish this topic today. So from tomorrow onwards, we'll start with Markov models and all. Okay, so let's see. So first of all, before processing each and every sentence in the corpus, what we do is we add start of the sentence symbol. This is the symbol after each and every sentence in our corpus. So after first sentence, before this first sentence, we will add start symbol over here. And similarly, we will add end symbol. We'll see what it does and why is it important. So we will add one end symbol over here, start symbol over here after every sentence, right? So why it is needed? So let's see. This is the probability for a bigram. So in a bigram, so to calculate the bigram probability for first sentence. So this, if you can see, so for the one word is missing, so context is incomplete, right? So to make this complete, we add a start symbol in the after every before every sentence. Okay, so we add this symbol. Now we use this probability as our first bigram probability while calculating the probability bigram probability for every sentence. Okay, so but what if we are calculating the probability of a trigram? So in trigram case, what happens is it will start from here, teacher, and these two will start. Formula would be like this. So this is a trigram. So in trigram, the same sentence is there, the teacher drinks tea. So if you see, so it will start from for the first word, there is no previous two words. There are no previous two words, so it cannot be. So context is missing again here over here. Then for teacher, we have the, but next word is missing, right? So for teacher, this one word context again is missing. But for drinks, we have this the and teacher. These two previous words are there. So now we can calculate the trigram probability. So this is fine and this is fine, right? So this problem is solved by adding two start symbols. So two start symbols are added. Now if you want to calculate the probability of this whole sentence, what you will do is you will start from here. The given start symbol and start symbol already appear. So this is your first probability. Your second probability will be a given teacher. Then the and start symbol, right? And then multiplication of next and next. So the probability of occurrence of this whole sentence would be like this. So to make sentences more complete, we add these start symbols. Okay. Similar thing is with ending sentence. So after this, we add one ending sentence after every sentence, ending token. Example is, okay, let's see this example. So we have this is the corpus with having three sentences, and this is the possible set of sentences that can be generated. It is a two word length of each and every sentence is two word, right? In this corpus, possible number of two word sentences are yes, 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 no, 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 yes. These are the possibilities. Basically, we can see maybe vocabulary or possible set of sentences of two words, and there is a start symbol. So this is the possibility that can occur, right? Now, if I calculate the probability of this first sentence, okay, so how I will calculate? So probability of sentence one, maybe S, yes, and yes, is equals to, if I calculate the bigram probability, so in bigram it would be probability of yes given start symbol multiplied by probability of yes given yes, right? And now we have to calculate this. So how do we do that? So probability of yes given start symbol is how much? So start symbol is appearing 3 times, and after yes is appearing after start symbol 2 times. So that is 2/3, right? Over here, 2/3. And probability of yes given yes. So yes is appearing only 1 time and in the whole corpus, and out of which only yes is appearing 2 times. So that would be 1/2. So if you multiply this, you will get 1/3. This 1/3 is coming like this. So for each and every sentence, you can calculate the probability of occurrence of that sentence. And if you sum all these up, you will get 1. Right? So, this part is clear. Like, you have to calculate the probability of each and every sentence. And for calculating the probability of each and every sentence, you divide each and every sentence into a set of bigrams, that bigrams, trigrams, or n-grams, whatever you are considering. Okay, so you will calculate the probability of first sentence, second sentence, and you sum them up. And if you sum them up, all these, you will get 1, because in your corpus, only 3 sentences were there. No yes was not there, so probability is 0. So if you sum all of these possibilities, this should be 1, definitely, right? So this is scenario where we have a 2-word length sentences. So maximum length, or maybe you can see equal, all the sentences were of a 2-word length, right? Now, in our general text that we are having, in general scenarios, we don't have 2-word sentences fixed. So we have 2-word sentences, we have 3-word sentences, we have 4-word sentences, right? So what we want in the real world is we want the sum of all the types of those to be 1. So what we want in general scenarios is similarly, this is example of 3-word sentences. So here, if you possible number of sentences are 8. 2^3. So yes, no, and so on. So there are 8 sentences, right? And sum of all the three-word sentences is again 1. But in real world, you would be having 2-word sentences plus 3-word sentences plus 4-word sentences in your corpus. So what you want is sum of all those should be 1, right? So in real world, you want 2-word sentences to be 1, 3-word, and so on. So that is why. So to reduce this probability, which is actually coming 1. So we want this not to be 1. We want this to be somewhat less than 1. Similarly, over here, we don't want some of all the probabilities of 2-word sentence to be 1. We want it to be less than 1. So to avoid this problem, we add end of sentence token. So whenever you are adding one more word, one more token in your corpus or in a sentence, definitely all the probabilities would reduce. Definitely that will happen. So we are just solving this problem by ending just one end of the token symbol over here. And if you now calculate the probability of those sentences, this would reduce. This would reduce to some value so that sum of this plus this plus this would be 1. Sum of all the possible sentences would be 1. Okay, so that is why we add 1, and in general scenarios, we add 1 end of the symbol token after each sentence. Okay, because sentences, variable length sentences are there. Okay, so this is, so before processing n grams, first of all, you have to, so step 1 was you have to clean your data set. Then you have to you have to decide which n grams you want to use. You want to use bigram, trigram, n grams up to n, which are making more sense to your data set. You have to decide that. And after that, after deciding that, okay, you are using 2 gram plus 3 grams for your model. After that, what you have to do is you have to add the start and ending symbol to your sentences. Now, let's come to step four. So up till step three, everything is clear. Anything, any doubt?
Ma'am, like pehle we added before the sentence and we added one at the end of the sentence for calculation.
In general scenarios, we do that. We add only one because over here, if you calculate the probability over here, so that would be the like this and would be S and S. So this makes sense. While if over here, if you check, so it would be like this. If you add one more symbol in the end for a trigram, right? So if you are adding like this, so this is actually chances of appearing end of the sentence given these two. So this is generally doesn't make sense. We don't want this, like we don't want it to be key. What are the chances of occurrence of given end symbol, given already ending symbol? So it's already ending. Getting my point? It's like, if you are there, if you are, you have reached here, this means you are already reached to the end of the sentence. So in general scenarios, we generally add only one ending symbol and multiple start symbols. Because conditional probability is like next word, this word is important. So end symbol is not important in that sense to our. Okay, so this is the reason. To calculate the probabilities, what you can do, suppose you have a big corpus. So what you can do is first you have to generate the count matrix. And count matrix, in generating this count matrix, basically process the corpus into a count matrix that counts the number of occurrence of relative n-grams. So this step-by-step procedure, five steps that are written over here, these are making your calculation simpler. Okay, then you have to generate the probability matrix, transform the count matrix into probability matrix. And this probability matrix contains information about conditional probability of n grams. So suppose you have a very big data set and so many sentences are there, and you are asked to calculate the probability of some any sentence from this whole corpus. Okay, so in that case, what you will do is, so it's difficult to calculate this by reading, because if you have three sentences, it's easier, like counting 1, 2, 3. Okay, three occurrences are there, so many things become easier. So this is the step-by-step procedure. So first you have to generate count matrix. You have to count all the values in the whole data set. You have to generate probability matrix, and then you have to relate your probability matrix to language model. Basically what you want to do, basically you want to find out the probability of a sentence or something, you want to predict next word, anything that you want to do, then you will do. So after all the pre-processing steps that you have done till now, you have to generate a count matrix and you have to generate a probability matrix. Okay, then you will calculate the final probability of occurrence of a sentence, or you'll model your language, whatever you want to do. Then after that, this I'll tell you what it is, and let's see the sample example. This is application, how we'll go through it. Let's see. Okay, so first of all is count matrix. So in count matrix, this is a bigram. So this is first bigram. So you write first S over here and I over here. So this value is 1 because it is appearing, right? Rest all are zeros, because after start there is no ending, there's no study, there's no learn after. So these are not appearing. So this is just count matrix, values of all the bigrams that are appearing in your corpus. Okay, similarly, you have to generate a probability matrix. So count matrix is nothing. If it's a bigram, you are generating a 1 by 1 count of each and every values that are present. So making things simpler. Okay, then you, what you will do is you will generate a probability matrix. So probability matrix is nothing. You just sum all these rows and you put it over here and you divide value by sum. So this is 1 by 1, 1 by 1. Then you sum all these rows. So it's already 0. You sum all these rows. So this is 2. So you divide this by 2 and you divide this by 2. So this is 1 by 2. This is 1 by 2. Okay. So it's just one and the same thing that we have done previously. So previously what we were doing, we were counting, like we were counting these values and then we were generating the probability. Now probability of occurrence of a sentence is the multiplication of all these. Okay. Multiplication of this one, this one, this one. Like this. Okay. So this is count matrix, probability matrix. Now after calculating, so probability matrix is nothing. It's just giving you idea like which word, which bigram is appearing, how many count of each and every bigram. Okay. So this is just a value. And now using this probability matrix, you are going to use that probability matrix in creating your language model. Okay. So what, so for this sentence, so this is your first bigram. So probability of S I is, you have to take this from here. S and I. So this is value. So you put one over here, then you learn comma I, second bigram, learn and I. So over here, so you put one over here, then sorry, one learn and I and learn. So this is I and learn. So this is I and this is learn. So this one, 0.5. There is a what you can say, whenever I get confused in whenever it is A, B in a sentence, so it is B by A, right? So okay. So getting my point right, so this is I and this is learn. So first you have to see I and learn. So you have to check this row and this column. This, so value is 0.5. Over here, this is S and learn. So S, this is ending sentence. So first we have to check learn. So learn and S, so this is 1. So 1.51. So calculating the probability of the sentence using the probability matrix. So this is making just things simpler. So how you will do while you are coding, you have to create a, first of all, that pre-process the whole data set. You have to create a count matrix. Then you have to generate a probability matrix. You have to search for probability matrix for calculating each and every probability. If you are asked in exam as well, if you are asked this probability or any random probability, so you have to check that probability matrix. Okay, so any doubt in this up till here? So this is easy. Okay, so there is a limitation. So what happens is, suppose this was only 4-word sentence. Suppose you have a 10-word sentence. So this is 1 cross 0.5 cross 1. 4-word sentence, it would be 1, 0.1, 0.1, 0.1. And so many sentences were there in the corpus. So probability is 0.0001, right? So values are very, very small when data set is large. And in general scenarios, data sets are large, having thousands of sentences, right? So values are very, very small. So to avoid this, what we do is we take log on the both sides. So when I'm talking about taking log, so if I'm talking about a sentence having 4 words, so it's sentence W1, W2, W3 and W4. So, and if I'm talking about bigram probability, so that is W2 by W1, right? PW3 by W2, right? PW4 by W3. I have ignored this start and end over here. So you have to add those two as well. Multiply those two as well over here. So suppose this is the probability of a bigram model with 4 words, right? So what you will do is, instead of doing that, you take log both sides. So you apply log over here, you apply log over here. Now, if you apply log over right hand side, you will get, so whenever you have log A into B, you will get log A plus log B. So you open this up, you get log of this first PW2 by W1 plus log of second PW3 by W2 plus this, right? So this, this seems simpler, right? So if you have a value like 10 to the power minus 1, 10 to the power minus 1, 10 to the power minus 1. If you take a log, you don't have to right now have to multiply 10 to the power minus 1 and 10 to the power minus 1. You just have to add them. So this value would become minus 1, this value would become minus 1, and this value would become minus 1. So value is minus 3. So instead of 0.001, it is now minus 3. Okay, so to avoid working with very small numbers, you are having some bigger numbers. So that is the only thing. So you just have to, whatever you have done, all the calculations, in the end, you have to take log on the both the sides. Okay, and you have to solve your problem, whatever your answer is. So this is, I'm telling, like, numerical part. So in numericals, what you have to do is, you have to first find out individual probabilities, individual bigram or trigram, whatever is given. Individual probabilities you have to find out. And then after that, instead of multiplying, you have to take log on both the sides, and then you have to add those probabilities. Okay. So this is done to avoid underflow in the computer system. So in computer system, if you are doing 0.00001, so this goes to underflow. So that's why we take log on both the sides. Okay, now let's see the application. So application of this is generating the whole sentence. So given Lin, if I want to generate next word in the sequence, okay, so how I can do that? So for generating the sentence, so application of language model is generating a sentence. First was like where you are calculating the probability of occurrence of a sentence in the whole corpus. Instead, here you want to generate what is the next word in the whole sequence. Okay, what Lin is doing. I want to know what Lin is doing. Okay, so you want to generate that. So algorithm for that is, you have given a set of corpus, and question is Lin dash, what Lin is doing. So you want to know. So you have given sentence starting of the sentence is given to you, and now you want to know the probability. Okay, so what you will do is, you will find out all those words in the whole corpus where start symbol is there and where Lin is there, right? You want to know that Lin is this in this whole sentence, where Lin is the first word. I want to know. So you will find the whole corpus, and you will say, okay, Lin is appearing over here and over here in the two sentences, and you will find out the probability of this bigram, and you will find the probability of this bigram. Okay, now out of this and out of this, let's say probability of this was more, so you select this one and you say, okay, so this is my first starting from where I will be starting. I will be generating sentence from here. Okay, now next is fir uske baad, after you have selected the starting of your sentence, what you want is, okay, what so maybe question is what Lin is drinking. Okay, so you will again calculate where Lin and drink appearing together. Lin and drinks are appearing together. Okay, you will search the whole corpus. Okay, so you will get Lin and drink is appearing over here. Okay, so you will find again the probability of this, and you select this one, and so on. So you say, okay, Lin drink something. So you output next word, and so on. So this process is repeated. Okay, so because after that, so you will find all the words after that. Suppose what it is drinking. So after drinks, there is drink chocolate and drink tea. Now you have two options. So probability of chocolate and tea, whichever is higher, so that will be returned. So if it says, okay, drinks tea is higher, so next it will print, it will output drinks tea. Then again, so this process is repeated. So this is how a next word is generated given the problem, given your input or start of your sentence. Okay, so this is the application.
Ma'am, shouldn't the probability of an individual bigram independent of the sentence?
Probability of bigram independent of the sentence?
Yes, ma'am.
Probability of a bigram definitely depends upon what previous word is occurring, but how it is independent? It is dependent upon previous word that is occurring.
No, ma'am. Like you said, like there were S lane occurring two times, and you selected the first one.
Okay, so you are saying ki this is out of whole corpus. So if I'm talking about only one sentence, but in generating, whenever I'm generating a language, so in that case, we check the probability throughout the whole corpus instead of the checking the probability of one sentence. Because in language modeling, when I'm talking about the probability of one sentence in the whole, you know, a whole set of sentences, if I'm talking about what is the probability of occurrence of this sentence in the whole sequence, in that case I will take it as individual. I'll multiply all those values and I will say, okay, the probability despite what other sentences are there, so I will just multiply it and I will say okay. But while generating, while I'm talking about generative model, in that case we consider the other bigrams as well. Like we consider the whole, obviously while calculating each and every bigram, suppose bigram is there. So this probability of this bigram is checked throughout the corpus, right? It's not checked in the whole, only one sentence only. Each and every bigram, for example, if, let's see over here. So this, if probability of yes, this yes I'm calculating, so this yes is counted from here and from here. Okay, so 2 out of 3 is number of times it is appearing in the whole corpus. While here, so your question is, right, so what will happen is it will count like what is the probability of occurrence of S lin in the whole corpus out of where, out of all the lins were there, right? Out of all the for example, in drinks chocolate and in drinks tea, so lower part is drink, so out of drink chocolate plus drink tea plus all those were there, so out of all those bigrams, out of all the possible bigrams where drinks is appearing first, given the tea is higher or the chocolate is higher. Getting my point? So question, so this is out of all the starting sentence, so for first, how we will calculate the probability of this? This probability will be calculated given start of the sentence is there, so it can be start lin plus probability of start and Lynn, plus probability of start and John.
If it's probabilistic, then if Lynn occurs almost always after the start symbol, mm-hmm. So it will, if we are making a generative language model, wouldn't it always output S Lynn in the beginning? If you have to start from default. मतलब जीरो से अगर स्टार्ट करते तो मतलब इफ आई हैव टू स्टार्ट अ सेंटेंस
सो क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट लिन इज डूइंग सो वी हैव टू गिव समथिंग सो इफ यू आर जनरेटिंग अ सेंटेंस यू ऑलवेज हैव टू गिव फर्स्ट वर्ड एज इनपुट कि वी वांट लिन एज फर्स्ट वर्ड.
सो मैम इवन आफ्टर दैट विल इट नॉट ऑलवेज आउटपुट द सेम सेंटेंस बिकॉज़ प्रोबेबिलिटी तो सेम रहेगी ना मतलब लाइक कॉर्पस में
सेम क्यों रहेगी क्योंकि ड्रिंक्स चॉकलेट है ड्रिंक्स टी है दो ऑप्शंस है ना तो दोनों में से जिसकी हाई होगी वो उसको आउटपुट करेगा
बट मैम सेम ही आउटपुट होगा ना हमेशा यूनिफॉर्म होगा ना इन द सेंस कि अगर हमने एस लिन ड्रिंक्स लिखा तो हमेशा एस लिन ड्रिंक्स के बाद वही आउटपुट करेगा जिसकी मैक्सिमम प्रोबेबिलिटी होगी पर वो मैक्सिमम प्रोबेबिलिटी तो कांस्टेंट रहेगी
हां
या हम इसमें मतलब ऐसे रैंडमली पिक कर सकते हैं ताकि डिफरेंट सेंटेंस जनरेट हो
रैंडमली के लिए अब ये इस पे डिपेंड देखो टेस्ट सेट पे डिपेंड करता है अब हम हर बार टेस्ट सेट को डिवाइड करते हैं डिफरेंट डिफरेंट पार्टीशंस में हम क्रॉस वैलिडेट कर रहे हैं तो उस टाइम पे हो सकता है क्रॉस वैलिडेशन के टाइम पे कुछ और आउटपुट आए क्रॉस वैलिडेशन में अगर हमने 10 पार्टीशंस में डिवाइड किया है तो उस टेस्ट सेट जो टेस्ट सेट जब हम जनरेट कर रहे हैं तो हम टेस्ट सेट पर जनरेट कर रहे हैं ना तो उस टाइम पे अब वो जो टेस्ट सेट में जो सैम्पल्स हैं वो अलग अलग हो सकते हैं कभी कुछ और हो सकते हैं कुछ और हो सकते हैं तो उसके बेसिस पे आउटपुट चेंज हो जाएगा लेकिन ये है कि हम चाहते तो यही है कि हमेशा ड्रिंक्स टी ही आउटपुट आए
यस मैम आई थिंक वही आएगा मतलब बिकॉज प्रोबेबिलिस्टिकली तो वही मोस्ट मतलब प्रोबेबल है मैम क्विज है क्या आज वैसे मतलब
क्विज है
मतलब कोर्स में और लोग भी हैं ना लेकिन यहाँ पे सिर्फ 5 लोग दिख रहे हैं हाँ
5 लोग दिख रहे हैं
चलो मैं इनक्लूड करते हैं
कोर्स में है 7 स्टूडेंट्स एनरोल्ड है अभी तक तो लेट्स सी बाकी दो कौन नहीं आया
एक तो ध्रुव ही है हम उसको तो बुला लेंगे एंड दूसरा पता नहीं कौन है
अच्छा ओके मैं कौन है
आर्यन
आर्यन आर्यन तो है यहाँ पे
ईशान ईशान
अच्छा आर्यन है
ईशान ईशान में था हाँ ईशान में था
चलो लेट्स मूव ऑन टू नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इस ये वाला इसमें कोई अभी कोई डाउट था जो वो वाला वो तो समझ आ गया ना कि क्या मैं कहना चाह रही थी
ना मैं जारी डाउट नहीं था वो बस ये था कि मतलब मॉडल काफी खराब सा है इन द सेंस कि मतलब उसमें जनरेशन भी क्या ही हो रही है एग्जैक्टली
तो इस ऐसा नहीं है कि इसमें इसमें इसीलिए हम क्या करते हैं हमेशा 2 ग्राम्स 3 ग्राम्स प्लस 4 ग्राम्स सबको ऐड करके तभी हम इसमें रिजल्ट निकालते हैं और मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम हम इसमें मतलब यही है कि हमें ये देखना पड़ेगा कि हमारा जो डेटा सेट है वो किस तरह का है अब हमारा डेटा सेट में 2 2 ग्राम्स वाले ज़्यादा इम्पॉर्टेंट हैं या वो चीज़ें हमें थोड़ा देखना पड़ेगा जब हम इस पर ये वाला मॉडल लगाएंगे ऐसा नहीं है कि इसके रिजल्ट अच्छे नहीं आते या वो हमेशा स्पेसिफिक ही रहते हैं ऐसा नहीं है
हाँ इसमें मतलब समझ गया मतलब लाइक कंबाइन मतलब स्किप ग्राम टैग्स भी कर सकते हैं मतलब बहुत पॉसिबिलिटी है मतलब
राइट और इसमें और इसके आगे और भी मॉडिफिकेशंस हैं जो जो इसमें और प्रपोज किए गए कि आप ये भी कर सकते हो तो वो चीज़ें हैं ओके सो इवैल्यूएशन ये लास्ट टॉपिक है इसके बाद विल गो टू क्विज इसमें इवैल्यूएशन के टाइम पे यू नो दैट यू आर डिवाइडिंग योर डेटा सेट इनटू ट्रेनिंग वैलिडेशन एंड टेस्ट एंड जनरली हम टेस्ट को बिल्कुल अलग ही रखेंगे जैसे हम हमेशा करते हैं बट इसमें क्या है कि जनरेटिव मॉडल जब हम लगाएंगे या फिर हम कोई लैंग्वेज मॉडलिंग लगा रहे हैं तो हम वो टेस्ट पे फाइनल रिजल्ट्स निकालेंगे और हम कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी टेस्ट डेटा की चेक करेंगे कि भाई इवैल्यूएट जो करेंगे वो टेस्ट पे करेंगे कि हाँ अभी हमारा मॉडल इज़ वर्किंग फाइन और नॉट ठीक है क्योंकि जो ट्रेन हमने किया है वो सीन डेटा दैट वाज सीन डेटा एंड ऑन ट्रेनिंग डेटा पे वी नो कि ये किस तरह से बिहेव करना चाहिए हमें ये नहीं पता टेस्ट पे वो कैसे बिहेव करेगा तो टेस्ट की लेट्स सी इवैल्यूएट करने के बहुत सारे मेथड्स हैं लाइक एंट्रोपी क्रॉस एंट्रोपी एंड सो मेनी अदर मेथड्स आर देयर टू इवैल्यूएट सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस परप्लेक्सिटी टुडे तो परप्लेक्सिटीज नाउ स्प्लिटिंग के भी लेट्स सी कि पहले ये देख लेते हैं स्प्लिटिंग कैसे करनी है अब टेस्ट डेटा में क्योंकि सेट ऑफ सेंटेंसेज वी हैव एंड दी सेंटेंसेज ईच एंड एवरी सेंटेंसेज ऑफ वेरिएबल लेंथ तो व्हाट हैपन्स इज कि इन द अब आपके पास दो मेथड्स हैं कि आप या तो उस पूरे के पूरे होल पैराग्राफ को, या फिर ऐसे कह सकते हैं 10 जो ट्रेनिंग सैंपल्स हैं आपके पास, तो उस पूरे को एक ही मानो और उसके उसमें केवल वर्ड्स स्प्लिट कर दो. तो अगर 10 सेंटेंसेस थे और हर एक में 10 वर्ड्स थे, तो आप 100 वर्ड्स मानो और उन 100 को 80-20-20 वर्ड्स में डिवाइड कर दो. एक तो मेथड ये है. दूसरा यह है कि आप उसको शॉर्ट शॉर्ट सीक्वेंसेस ईच एंड एवरी कुछ कुछ सीक्वेंसेस में उसको रैंडमली डिवाइड करो कि आप ओके आप ये बोल रहे हो कि 10 सेंटेंसेस आपके पास हैं, तो आप उसमें से 8 सेंटेंसेस आप ट्रेनिंग में रखोगे, 1 सेंटेंस. तो सेंटेंस पूरा पूरा आपने सीक्वेंस रखा है इंस्टेड ऑफ कंसिस्टिंग एज अ सेट ऑफ वर्ड्स. ठीक है, तो डिपेंड्स अपॉन यू कि आप उसको किस तरह से स्प्लिट करते हो. देन परप्लेक्सिटी. सो परप्लेक्सिटी इज नथिंग, इट्स जस्ट अ मेजर ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी. अब when I'm talking something, I'm saying something. So if I'm saying a sentence, so generally it's a simple sentence ki okay we are talking and it's right. So agar koi aisa sentence hai jaise ki randomly generated sequence of words hai, so if random collection of words are there, so that is considered to be more complex in a human according to human natural language, kyunki we are communicating in some language, so that is we consider okay this is simple kyunki we are able to communicate, right? So if I am if machine is generating words which are not related to human language, which are something random words, so we say okay this is having high complexity. And whatever we are talking or we are saying something, though, so any natural language is there, so that is having low complexity. Okay, so what we want for our model is to generate those sequence or those set of words which are having low complexity, understandable by human, close to what humans understand, right? So that is perplexity. And formula for perplexity is, suppose you are having m words in a sentence, so you just normalize it, you calculate its probability and you normalize it simply. Now there are two things, so this is just example where we have 100 samples. Probability of occurrence of that basically test set where you are having 100 words or the whole sentence W with 100 words. So probability of that is 0.9. So 0.9 probability is higher. And if you calculate the perplexity, because you are taking the square root to the power minus m, so it is calculated as whatever value. So this is very low. So low perplexity is considered good, while high perplexity is considered bad for your model. So we want like low perplexity. Now there are three things. Suppose in your whole data set, you have divided your sentence into set of words. You can divide your sentence into set of characters, and you can either keep your whole data set as a one sentence or one input, okay, that you can take. So you have three options. Now, what you want, so in general scenarios, what should happen? So complexity, basically perplexity of character level model is always lower than word-based model. Why? Because it's even more simpler, A, B, C, D, you have fixed set of characters. And as if you are calculating the complexity of the whole words, so that is even, it's more, a little bit more complex, right? So this is in the general scenarios. So what you can also do is, perplexity of bigram model they have created. So in a bigram model, you have jth word in the ith sentence. So first you calculate the probability of whole sentence and you multiply it by bigram, each and every bigram, and you calculate the probability of one sentence. Then you multiply the probability of all the sentences. So this is what this formula is. So first of all, you are calculating the probability of each and every word in a sentence, which is a bigram, a probability of one sentence. And then you multiply all the, you take product over all the m sentences that you are having, right? So this is general scenarios. What if you concatenate all the sentence in one W, in one sequence? If you concatenate them, it's just a simply one by, you are just multiplying the bigram probability. So in general scenarios, we do this. Okay, so you can use any of these. So just a simple example, and you can also take log of the perplexity if you're in some research papers they use log perplexity instead of simple perplexity to make things more simpler. Okay, so that's it. This is just example. So you can see if you are calculating the perplexity, unigram, bigram, trigram. So trigram perplexity is lower over here. Why? Because 109 and 170, there is a difference. So trigram perplexity is more because three words at a time makes more sense than two words at a time. And one word is not telling you anything about the data set. So one word is 962, very high complexity. So this is just, that's it for today. Let's start with the quiz. I think time is, I'm making quiz available on LMS. You can check if it's visible or not. Our time limit is 10 minutes. 6 questions are there. Very easy. I'm checking ki iski settings is not okay. Yes, abhi aa gaya hoga. No negative marking.
I'm aa gaya.